Someone else can compose music for you. Someone else can perform music for you. No one on earth can listen to music for you. Someone else can compose music for you. Someone else can perform music for you. No one on earth can listen to music for you. Someone else can compose music for you. Someone else can perform music for you. No one on earth can listen to music for you. Someone else can compose music for you. Someone else can perform music for you. No one on earth can listen to music for you. Someone else can compose music for you. Someone else can perform music for you. No one on earth can listen to music for you. Someone else can compose music for you. Someone else can perform music for you. No one on earth can listen to music for you. Someone else can compose music for you. Someone else can perform music for you. No one on earth can listen to music for you. Someone else can compose music for you. Someone else can perform music for you. No one on earth can listen to music for you. Someone else can compose music for you. Someone else can perform music for you. No one on earth can listen to music for you.
Is poor, his life in the concert hall will be short. This is true of popular singers as well as leader singers. Radio has acquainted the public with the best in serious music, and unless they are reasonably sure of hearing good performances of work, they stay away from the concert hall. Mail is one of our most potent indications of public taste and its wishes in the matter of programming. However, it is not the only way of finding out what the public listens to. There are such things as surveys made by telephone and house-to-house canvassing, which are also good cross-sections on the subject. I do not agree with a group of musicians who claim that radio should be like a doctor who feeds his patients only what he thinks is good for them. It's too easy for them to turn the dial. I also think that the person who writes a letter saying, "Why all this jazz?" or another who writes, "Why must we have to listen to that or this modern music?" But these persons do not consult their radio schedules and their newspapers. After all, if there's something going on in which you're not interested, there are probably millions of others who are enjoying it, and you should tune in at a time when you can hear what you want. From the standpoint of radio, because I'm in radio. Thank you.
in everybody's life, and I don't care how well you play or how well you sing or how well you do anything, the greatest thing in your life is really the experience you get from music, whether you produce the sound yourself or somebody else produces it. And in order to have that experience, you've got to be an active listener. And in order to be an active listener, you've got to develop yourself. Because after all, my dear friends, Beethoven had to develop himself, and Paderewski had to develop himself. Every performer and every composer who ever lived, why should the layman say, I don't have to do anything? And why should we ever say that we don't need to understand music? We hear when the sound reaches our consciousness. We don't hear without that consciousness. And the way our consciousness functions is what is going to make us have some idea of what we want in music. And only then will we be able to know it. If you only have certain types of musical experience, you can't possibly know about the others.